In my previous video, I talked about how I think the visual style of the show should have been like. I said that they should have done it as a retro future kind of look to make it look advanced and futuristic, but also stylistic and similar to the original series in the visual style of things. And I gave examples from other shows and movies which did use that kind of idea of a retro future, which I always found kind of neat and interesting and artistic. So I think that's the only way to do a proper prequel to TOS, especially if it's very close to the time frame of TOS. It has to be visually similar. It doesn't have to be identical, and it doesn't have to look cheap as if it's all made from plywood and so on. It can look advanced and futuristic, but also stylistically similar in a retro kind of way, which I think would also be artistic and fun, just like all those other shows and movies I mentioned. So anyway, so that was about the visual side of things. Now I want to talk about the story, the plot of the series, which I think did have some potential. When that show started, I didn't really like the first two episodes, but in the third episode, when they introduced the Discovery, I did find it intriguing. I did find a lot of those elements interesting. And in my reviews of all those episodes, I also gave my theories for what I thought is going to happen next, and yet most of it didn't really happen. And I didn't completely hate the first season. I did like a lot of things in it, such as Captain Lorca. I even liked the design of the Discovery ship itself. Even the spore drive, I could have accepted it a lot better if it was explained properly, and I'll get to that in a moment on how it should have been done. And even the alien makeup of the Klingons, I think it could have been great if it simply wasn't the Klingons. If it was used on a different alien species, then it could have been cool and it wouldn't have pissed off all the fans. So it was a huge mistake to do that to the Klingons, who were an established species. There was no need to change them. Small change would have been fine, but such a radical shift, making them into something totally different, was a huge mistake. They should have done that with a different alien species. Another huge missed opportunity was not to use the Sheliak, which were an exotic alien species that appeared in one episode of Star Trek TNG, and it was said that they had a peace treaty with the Federation, and an exact date was given of when the peace treaty was signed, and it actually was the same year that it was set in the first season. So that was a huge missed opportunity. It was said in TNG that there was some kind of conflict or even a war with the Sheliak until an elaborate peace treaty was signed with them, which lasted up until TNG. That means no more conflicts from that point on. So this is a missed opportunity that cannot be used again. So I think that could have been so easily put in the first episode or the first few episodes of the show, and it could have accomplished a few things. First of all, it would fit perfectly with the timeline, as I said. It's something that was mentioned in TNG. It's also an exotic alien, so this could have been a great opportunity to really show off their special effects and their makeup and all of that. All we saw from the Sheliak was some kind of strange biomass moving. They seemed to be not humanoids, which is a very cool idea, and we didn't see their full form, and it's possible what we saw was kind of a covered up version of a Sheliak. Maybe it's something they were on top of their true form, so they could have done almost anything with this species, because we didn't really see almost nothing from it except the general shape of it. But then have them uncover and do whatever you want. You can play around with it and make them into a very exotic and creepy and strange alien, and it would fit continuity. Instead, what did they do? The first episode had that mission to the planet with the exotic aliens. So that was them showing off the new effects and showing an alien which is not humanoid, which is fine, but why not do that later? Why not first do something which fits the timelines, such as showing off the Sheliak? So I think the first episode should have been about signing the treaty with the Sheliak. They could show that Michael and Giorgio go on a diplomatic mission to sign this treaty, which took the Federation a lot of time to prepare and so on. So this could be like the final signing of it, and then the Sheliak maybe start doing some trouble, and then Michael somehow is able to get them to sign the treaty anyway, so shows her off as a clever character who is a very good diplomat. Or maybe do that with Giorgio, that would also be fine, even though I think it's pointless to develop Giorgio's character too much, because if she gets killed off early on in the series, then what's even the point to try to build up her character? So I think maybe Michael should have done something to convince the Sheliak not to back out in the last moment. So that could have been great scene in the spirit of Star Trek, and also show off an exotic alien with the brand new special effects, and it would tie perfectly with continuity with TNG. So I would have loved that. I always wanted to see more of the Sheliak, because they were a very exotic, interesting looking alien, very mysterious, so I wouldn't actually mind seeing more of them. So seeing them in this prequel when they signed the treaty, which later Picard had to deal with and use the same treaty to solve a problem with them. That would have been very neat, in my opinion. So this was a huge missed opportunity, which cannot come again because the date doesn't match anymore. So that was literally the exact year in which the show started. So I think that's what should have been done in the very first episode. It would have shown that Starfleet is peace-seeking and diplomatic and all of that, everything that is the spirit of Star Trek. They could use the Shellyak to show off brand new special effects, but in a way that doesn't contradict the original, and tie with continuity perfectly, and also show off our new characters as diplomatic, peaceful. I think we should have had at least one or two episodes before the war even started to get to know some of these characters in a positive, good light, in the normal, bright future, the peaceful future, with the Star Trek spirit, and get to know the characters and care about them before we see them get sucked out into space and everything. Because when it happened in the show so fast, before we get a chance to know any of them, we didn't care. We didn't care about that guy who got sucked out. We barely knew him. He had like one or two lines before that, so why should we care when he dies? So they should have took the time and do at least one episode before the war with the Klingons and all of that. And the Klingons should have looked much closer to how we knew them in TNG. It would have been clever to mix them up to show that some Klingons actually do look human because of what happened in Enterprise. And you know, the whole copyright thing, they say that one of the reasons they had to change the Klingons was because they had to make them look different. But can anyone really copy a human appearance of an alien? Like, if you show aliens who look like humans, can anyone really claim that that's copyrightable, that you cannot show human looking aliens, because it's copyrighted? Like, it's crazy. It doesn't sound logical at all to me that it can be copyrighted. What can be is maybe the uniforms and so on. So why not simply show the Klingons as human looking but with different uniforms and different way of dressing? And so they could have done a lot of variety with the Klingons. They could even show that some of the Klingons are more exotic looking, like these new Klingons. I would be fine with it if it wasn't all of them like that. And also, they could have saved so much money on not doing so much Klingon makeups, just having them look human, and use that money they spent on their makeup for other special effects on the show. Maybe for some other new alien they want to introduce in this show, that would be fine. And also, all the old fans will not get pissed off at the Klingons changing so much. So everybody would be happy, the show will be much better off, and also we'll be able to understand the Klingons because we'll be able to hear what they're saying. So everybody wins. The only disadvantage would have been that they couldn't do the Vok twist, because they showed the Vok in the makeup, and then they show Ash Tyler, and we could not have recognized him with all that makeup, so we didn't know that it's Vok, even though a lot of us guessed it anyway. But I guess that was one of the reasons they decided to do that heavy makeup for the Klingons, because that way we wouldn't know that it's the same actor. But if they wanted to have such a plot line of a Klingon spy, which is a good idea for the show, I think it should have been done, but simply show a new character with a new actor that we didn't see previously, show him getting rescued from a Klingon ship and then become part of the crew, and then later reveal that he's a Klingon spy, simply without showing him as Vok previously. And then it would still be a surprise, and so they didn't have to do that crazy makeup just to do this surprise. And also, they could say, since they gave him the appearance of a real human being, then he could have been played by two different actors and it would also be fine. But I think the best way would simply be to introduce him as Ash Tyler, have him become part of the crew, and then later do a surprise that he's a Klingon spy, and that would work perfectly. It would work even better, because we all guessed it because we saw Vok. We saw that Vok is going to do something to sacrifice everything, and then we see Ash Tyler getting easily rescued, and then we all kind of connected the dots, and we knew the surprise right away. But if we didn't see Vok previously, then we could not have guessed that he's a Klingon. So the surprise would have worked even better that way, and so that was another missed opportunity. And the whole Vok storyline didn't really go anywhere. The whole surprise thing didn't work, they dragged it out too long. I think it could have been a great surprise to reveal that one of the crew is a Klingon spy. It could have been done much better, in my opinion. As for the spore drive, I think it was a good plot device if they were planning to use it to jump the ship into distant parts of the universe, even though it's a prequel in which they're not supposed to reach all those far places, and this way they could do that, even though it's a prequel. The problem is that they had to explain it properly of why no one else had this piece of technology. Maybe they should have said that they found some Iconian technology and they're using that, and that they are unable to duplicate this technology, and so later on, if they lose it, if it gets destroyed, then they will lose all this ability. And so this way it would not be a problem with continuity with other shows. But the way they did it, they said that basically anyone can build this technology now in Starfleet. That's why it doesn't make sense. So they should have done it as a kind of a unique technology that cannot be replicated, maybe using some kind of Iconian artifact or something like that, maybe without mentioning the name even, as not to cause the question of how come Picard didn't know about this. So simply say, we found some ancient alien device which enables us to do these jumps. So that would be okay, because we will presume, okay, they lost it later, and that's why Starfleet didn't have this technology later, if they say that they cannot duplicate it. That they can't even figure out exactly how it works. You know, kind of like the Stargate in SG-1, that they had a Stargate that they found, they cannot duplicate it, they cannot build their own Stargates, and so if they lose the Stargate, they will lose the ability to go to other planets. And so it's not a problem. You know, in a way, Stargate can be a prequel to Star Trek without a problem, if they simply say that all the Stargates get destroyed later, then technically it's not a contradiction. So they could have done something like that in the show and say that they are using some kind of unique piece of technology they found which they cannot duplicate. And also they could have said that the ship is a secret ship that is run by Section 31. That would also be a neat way to explain how come all its missions were so classified that no one knew about it later. And it would also solve a lot of the continuity problems. And by the way, I made a whole bunch of compilations with all the continuity contradictions that the show created with other shows. I put it all on my other channel, Major Green. You can check it out. For example, in one episode, Commander Data said that no ship ever went deep into a planetary body. And yet on Discovery, we see them teleporting into the heart of the planet Kronos. So I guess that was classified. But a lot of stuff that happened on the show really shouldn't happen. At least not to be public knowledge. And so just have the ship be a Section 31 ship from the very beginning, and have Captain Lorca be a member of Section 31. That, I think, would have been a very cool idea. And now, I did like the twist they did with the Mirror Universe, that he's actually from the Mirror Universe. That's why he's so evil. But Lorca was interesting in the beginning, because we thought he's just a shady guy, that he's doing what he thinks is right to defend the Federation. And so in a way, that twist kind of ruined his character, because we find out actually he is a one-dimensional villain. He just thought about himself all that time, just wanted to get back to his universe, and that's why he was doing all of that. In a way, it kind of ruins the potential of what could have been such a great character. It could have been like Breaking Bad in space. Just like Walter White was kind of on a road to the dark side, doing what he thought was necessary for his family, and then becoming more and more evil. Imagine if you got something like that with the character of Lorca. So have him start out as a patriot who just wants to defend the Federation, then he's gradually willing to do more and more evil and shady stuff just to win the war, and then eventually he can become the villain of the show, and that would be a very interesting story arc. So that's something I would have wanted to see. A more gradual downfall of that character into the dark side, basically. They kind of implied it in his first appearance. Michael suspected that maybe he's developing a biological weapons, because she heard about the spores, and then he reveals to her that actually they're developing the new engine. So I think I prefer that other idea better. I would have preferred that idea of him doing illegal experiments on the ship and developing illegal weapons against the Klingons, and that's why he recruits Michael, because he thinks she's a criminal as well, and she started the war, and maybe he gathers a group of people like that, were much more shady, not the typical Starfleet officer. So I do think that could have made the show much more interesting, and they could show them doing a lot of nasty attacks against the Klingons, which are not sanctioned by the rest of Starfleet. That way you don't really ruin the universe of Star Trek. You're not making the rest of Starfleet look bad, as they did do in the actual show, because they say that everybody knows about the ship. We see all these admirals communicating with the ship, and then giving the orders to commit genocide against the Klingons in the end. So that was a very bad idea, to say that that's the orders of Starfleet Command, because by doing that, you basically make the whole Federation look bad. Instead, it should have been only the plans of Section 31, and the rest of Starfleet should have had no knowledge about all of this, and only this secret ship is doing all kinds of nasty attacks against the Klingons, which would have remained secret. And also in one episode, they showed that Lorca has a tribble, so when I saw that, I thought maybe they'll use that to explain why the tribble became the enemy of the Klingon Empire later. Maybe they can reveal that Captain Lorca genetically engineered the tribbles so that they'll reproduce so fast, and then maybe infest planets on which Klingons are growing their food with the tribbles in order to eliminate the Klingon food supply. That would have been a neat storyline also. And maybe the Klingons have even worse technologies, so they have to grow actual food to eat. And so maybe Lorca engineered the tribble. Maybe we can say it's an existing creature, because it did appear in the prequel Enterprise. So maybe he took an existing creature, but he enhanced its natural properties of reproduction in order to use it as a bioweapon to eliminate the enemy's food supply. So they could have revealed that he is the one who enhanced the tribbles to such a level, and then sent them to those Klingon planets And that would explain why the Klingons are starving. There was one episode in which it was mentioned that the Klingons are starving for food. So they could have explained that with the Tribble thing, and it would also explain why the Klingons later hated the Tribbles, and also why the Tribbles hated them. Maybe Lorca added that trait as well with genetic engineering to make them aggressive toward the Klingons and so on. So that would have been a funny and interesting idea, I think. And at some point you can show that he's getting crazier and crazier, and maybe Michael, who committed mutiny in the first episode, maybe she would be hesitant to commit one again, and only in the end of the season she finally decides to stand up to Lorca when he wants to commit genocide against the Klingon planet, only then have her do a mutiny again, and that would be like a full circle, only this time her mutiny will be justified. And also I think it would have been neat to turn Lorca into Garth of Izar, who was a villain in the original Star Trek show. And I think some of his dialogue in the original episode could have fit Lorca so perfectly, because he said that he explored much more space than any other captain before him, so if he had the spore drive, that would explain how he was able to do that. Also, it was said that he's a scientist who developed a whole bunch of weapons, so that also fits the Lorca we saw with that room with all those neat weapons. So that would all fit so perfectly. You could show Lorca or Garth as that kind of character who begins with good intentions, then slides into a necessary evil because of the war, and then later he becomes evil, and in the very end he can become insane, and then be defeated by his crew who commit mutiny, and in the very end be put into the asylum for the criminally insane, like a classic supervillain. So that could have been so cool. So it would tie well with continuity. It fits perfectly with that character who is a villain in the original show. Also, he had the ability to shapeshift, so they could also add that before he's finally captured. You can have that whole story with him meeting those aliens who can shapeshift and getting disfigured, and then they cure him with their powers, and then he also gains their powers of shapeshifting. And so he would be a villain with shapeshifting powers, which is also a very cool idea. They could do so much stuff with it, and only in the very end have him be arrested by Michael, and then put into the asylum for the criminal insane, like a classic supervillain, and that would also tie with the original series, so that could have been such a great storyline. So that was also a very big missed opportunity. Even though I did like what they did with the Mirror Universe, I also thought that was neat, but it could have been better. They could have saved the Mirror Universe thing maybe for later, maybe with another character, because I did like that idea as well. So that's why I didn't completely hate the show. I did like some specific elements of it, but I think they could have done a lot more. And with Vok being a Klingon spy, also I think they could have done it in so much better ways, have it be much more surprising and shocking and all of that. Instead, we got kind of a strange mix of dragged out story ideas of him having those PTSD flashbacks and all of that, which I found boring and uninteresting. And all that plot really was pathetic, like it was the worst plan ever. So he was a Klingon who pretended to be a human, then forgot he's a Klingon, then he helped out his enemies, basically. So that was a huge fail for that Klingon, so I don't like that. I would have much rather to have him as a recurring villain, to reveal him as a villain Klingon, but because of the time he spent with them, maybe he has mixed feelings, so he's not a one-dimensional villain, because he did connect with the crew, and so maybe he will be kind of a semi-villain later. Maybe he would help them achieve a truce with other Klingons, he could serve as a bridge between them and so on. So some of the ideas they showed could have been done much better. So these are my thoughts about the missed opportunities in this show, which would never come again. I don't think it's possible to do any of these ideas now, because it's too late now. So it's really too bad. It could have been a much better show than it was, in my opinion. So let me know what you think in the comments below and we can discuss it. And I will see you all next time. Bye bye.